In this quick video, I'm going to show you how to log some interesting info on application startup. And I'm going to share with you a simple, quick bin that I usually plug into any new system that I'm working on. It's a basic bin. I plug it in and I basically start logging interesting information when the application starts up. So we're going to create this bin now. I'm going to call it logging bin. It's a simple component. And of course, there are several ways of wiring up custom logic on the application startup. And we're going to go with a very simple way. We're going to make this bin implement initializing bin. And that's it. We're going to hook up our custom logic in here. Okay, first thing we're going to do is we're going to define a simple logger here. And the project is configured to use simple logging facade, and it's backed by logback. And we are going to also wire in the Spring environment, because we're going to make good use of this environment bin when we're going to start to actually log this kind of information. Okay, so let's start by segmenting this log and separating this from the rest of the log output of the project. We are also going to wrap all of this logging logic in a simple try catch, just so that we are sure that this doesn't have any side effect on the application startup. So in case of any kind of exception, we will just log the exception and move on. Now, what are we going to actually log? The first thing we're going to log is if the project uses any externally set environment variables, we are going to log these. These are important pieces of information to know when the application starts up and easily spot any kind of misconfiguration or any kind of problems in that respect. So let's log environment variables, and we're going to leave that as an empty method right now, and we're gonna start completing it and filling it in later on. The next thing we're gonna log is we're gonna log any Spring profiles that are active. Okay, so we're gonna call this active Spring profiles. And this is again another piece of information. If we are using Spring profiles, it's important to see those when the application starts up. And finally, we are going to log any other properties. So any properties that we might feel that are relevant. So we don't want to log all properties in the project, just because there might be a lot of them that are simply not relevant to see on startup. But there are certain properties that are always good to actually show on the screen, and if there's any kind of problem, to easily spot that problem and identify it. So we're going to create this method as well. And now let's actually start implementing these methods. Okay, the first thing we need is we need a utility method that is actually able to intelligently log all of this information and to do some extra checks. So I prepared this method here and we'll go through it very quickly. So this basically logs the value of a property, and you pass in the environment, you pass in the property key, a default value, and you pass in a list of acceptable property values. In case this particular property has just a very small subset of acceptable values, it's useful to actually check these values and make sure that the value that the property actually has is not, you know, misspelled or simply a wrong value. So what are we doing here? Well, very simply, we get the property value out of the environment. We make sure, of course, that if it's null, we say that there is no value for that key and we log the default value. Then we check the accepted property value. So if we are passing accepted property values, then we check that, you know, the value we got is actually among them, and then we return. So it's a very simple method, but quite useful for, you know, quickly implementing the body of these three log methods. Okay, so let's rearrange these three methods in the order we have them defined above. Okay, and let's start actually logging the environment variables first. So let's say that we are working with an environment property that is called env_target. So this is the environment property that we care to actually log. This of course can be different from project to project, but this is just an example of how you would go about logging this environment target in our case. So we're gonna do a get value of property. We're gonna pass in the environment. We're gonna pass in this property key, which is env_target. We are going to pass a default value, which is local in our case. And we are going to pass the list of accepted property values. So we're gonna say lists, new array list, and we're gonna have the accepted property values for the env target are the accepted environment targets in our system. And let's say that these are local and we have a, let's say we have a development environment, we have a staging environment, and we have a production environment. So this is a very simple way to grab this env_target value and to actually log some interesting information about it. And then we will simply log it. So we're gonna log the env_target and we are going to log the env_target value. So very simply, we got the log environment variable method implemented, and we are now logging the env_target environment variable in our project. Let's now log the active Spring profiles, and this is of course logging if we are using Spring profiles in this Spring application. We need to log the active profiles for that particular run of the application, and the key here is Spring profiles active. This points to the active profiles at runtime. So we will basically do the exact same type of logging here. Of course, we can point to the key here just so that we don't repeat that. And we're gonna have key and key here. And we're gonna change the value, or we can simply name it value. And one last thing here is that we might not want to pass in these default variables, just because when we have Spring profiles active, we could have a mix of a very broad different variations of these active profiles. So we don't want to restrict those to any accepted values. Many values might be accepted here. Okay, let's go forward and implement the logging of some relevant properties in the project. So we want to log, for example, we'll start by simply copying this implementation here. And what we want to log here is, let's say we want to look at the persistence properties, and let's say we want to log the JDBC URL, just because it's usually helpful to see what that is and to kind of see immediately what the persistence of the application is going to be. And so we want to just log this. And this is pretty much it. Of course, the default should be either null, or we can of course pass a default, but let's pass null in this case because we don't really have a default URL. If this is not specified, then that's going to be a problem, so we don't want to pass in a default. And that is pretty much the implementation. We are now logging environment variables, active Spring profiles, relevant properties in the project, and of course this can be extended to log pretty much any relevant information about the project. But this is very, very useful. Let's now actually run the application. Okay, here we go. So first of all, we are logging the env_target. However, we're not passing any explicit value for env_target, so it gets the default, which is local. Same thing for the active profiles. This particular application is not using active profiles, so that's why it's getting the default, which is local as well. And then we are getting the JDBC URL, which is gonna be H2. And so this immediately points us to a potential problem, because what I was expecting here is I was expecting MySQL to be the default. So I can immediately see that I need to fix something and I need to point this to MySQL. So this is why this is useful. You immediately get feedback when the application starts up. You immediately see what's going on. All right, hope this was helpful. See you next time.